Welcome to the life-changing world of omakase sushi, everybody. If you want to see some unconventional sushi varieties, you've come to the right place. What we got here are some top-notch seafood selections in downtown Kanazawa, Japan, and personally, I think it's pretty nice. So grab yourself a treat and take yourself a seat, because the show is about to begin. So I was strolling and patrolling around the mean streets of downtown Kanazawa. Word around the campfire is this place was a famous samurai stronghold from ancient times. Now, I don't know the exact details about all the history of this joint, but one thing I know for sure. Just perusing all these samurai swords and armor sets was making me feel a tad hungry. In fact, come to think of it, it was making me feel a real hungry. Lucky for me, Kanazawa ain't just famous for its samurai, it's also famous for its sushi, baby. So I moseyed and meandered on over to a famous local sushi establishment and got mentally prepared to get my fix. The place is called Sushi Tokoro Kazue, and as you can see, it's looking pretty Japanesey inside. Now, I don't know about you, but it seems legit to me, baby cakes, so I ordered up the omakase sushi lunch set. Now, call me crazy, but I personally think that omakase is the best way to eat sushi. I mean, instead of getting a cookie-cutter sushi set, you're getting a plate-by-plate recommendation from the sushi chef himself. It's a pretty nice way to chow down on raw fish flesh in my book. Anyway, first up we got some Aka-Ika sushi, also known as Neon Flying Squid Sushi. It's got some bamboo charcoal salt sprinkled on top, and it's supposed to be enjoyed sans soy sauce, so I took myself a bite and whoa boy. That squid was tasting delicate to the max with some nice charcoal flavors popping off. Strange as it may sound, that was actually a pretty nice flavor combo. Not only that, but we got a sweet-ass bird plate right there, and I think it's looking aesthetic beyond belief. So next up, we got some Thai sushi, also known as sea bream sushi, and apparently that fish was pickled inside some konbu seaweed. So I took myself a bite of that pickled fish meat, and it was indeed tasting quite pickled. Just a tad more pickled than I'm used to, but I must say it was pretty decent nonetheless. Now aside from utilizing top-notch bird plates, this restaurant also serves up some pickled vegetables instead of the usual pickled ginger. Seems to me like this Kanazawa-style sushi is a little bit different from the Tokyo-style sushi that I'm used to. They use different palate cleansers here, different plates, and different sushi seasonings. There's a subtle sophistication to this Kanazawa sushi, and I must admit, I like it a lot. I might even go as far as to say as I'm feeling pretty inspired right about now. Case in point, take a look at this Ama-Ebi, also known as sweet shrimp, complete with shrimp eggs. This is the first time I've ever seen this rare eggy-wig variety, so I slapped it down my throat so fast I almost had a whiplash. I frantically chewed through that shrimp's body and chomped through those eggy wigs like my very life depended on it. And lo and behold, that incredible bite had a delicate sweet flavor and a slight miso marination. So next up we got the Kajiki sushi, also known as the Swordfish sushi. Apparently this puppy was soaked in some onion soy sauce and then lightly grilled. So it's got an oniony, smoky flavor to it, which is quite nice, but right about now I'm wondering about this plate. There's a distinct lack of birds on that plate, which is slightly detracting from my eating experience, but that's okay. This floral placemat under the plate is looking quite nice, so I guess I can't complain. I mean, it's not like I need a bird plate, but it definitely adds to the eating experience, that's all I'm trying to say. And wait a minute, we got us a new plate over here. Do they perchance have some birds on that plate? Because I think that maybe, just maybe, they actually do. I guess that's just part of the whole mystery of the thing. That sushi chef expertly placed that sushi just to keep the suspense going. So with that said, let's move on to the aji sushi, also known as the horse mackerel sushi. I'm a pretty big fan of that horse mackerel flesh, although usually in Tokyo it's served with a little minced ginger on top. Now I am a fan of the ginger action, but I'll give it a whirl without, so I took myself a bite, and as soon as I did, I came to the simultaneous realization that there were some birdies on that plate. Man oh man, that aji sushi was hiding some magnificent to the max birds. And although that aji was tasting rich, fishy, and juicy, I do prefer it to have the ginger paste in the end. But anyway, next up we got the Torigai sushi, also known as the Japanese cockle sushi. What in the world is a cockle anyway? I think it's some kind of Buckwild bivalve, but I don't know exactly. I'm not a freaking marine biologist over here, people. I'm just a simple man trying to get my sushi on. Can you actually blame me, baby cakes? Anyway, when I bit down on that bivalve flesh, it was tasting delicate and slightly chewy with a char-grilled flavor. Overall, I would say it was a nice bivalve. A real nice motherfucking bivalve, so I decided to move on to the next piece of sushi. What we got here is the Maguro tuna that's been marinated in some rare green yuzu citrus juice. So I bit down on that tuna meat and I was kind of surprised. That citrusy floral zest was the best, and I must say, I've never quite had any tuna sushi like that before. So let's move on to the next plate of omakase sushi. Here we got a primo local fish called Nodoguro, and we got us some baby onion sprout action. Now as far as this Nodoguro is concerned, apparently Kanazawa is famous for it, and it's quite expensive. I've never seen this fish before, let alone heard of it, suffice to say, I was mighty excited to try it out. So I gave it a dip in a little soy sauce, and then I shoved it down my throat. And as soon as I did, I was simultaneously stunned, stumped, and stupefied. That Nodoguro had an incredibly complex texture that was fatty, juicy, tender, and almost ever so slightly crunchy. Suffice to say, that elegant sushi was like a fine wine among fishy-wishy flesh. So next up, it's time for the Menegi sushi, also known as the baby onion sprout sushi. This type of sushi is kind of rare to come across, so I'm pretty intrigued about how it might taste. And after glancing at that verdant green, I shoved that sushi down my throat like a hunger-crazed Homo sapien. And whoa, baby, not only did that taste refreshing as hell and delicate to the max, but it was the perfect follow-up to the previous sushi. And as if that isn't enough, we actually have a bird on that plate. If that right there ain't a visual flavor enhancer, then I don't know what is. Anyway, next on deck we got the Anago Maki, also known as the Conger Eel Hand Roll. And as you can plainly see, we got us some primetime eel just a-begging to be eaten. It's just chillaxing there, glistening in the light, almost as though it was born to be eaten by me, almost as though it was destined for it. By the way, check out that plate, baby cakes. It may be birdless, but it's still a pretty damn good plate. By the way, I don't know if I mentioned before, but Kanazawa does specialize in pottery, which would explain all this crazy-ass plate action. Anyway, I took myself a magnificent nibble out of that Anago flesh, and I was pleasantly surprised. Usually Anago just tastes like low-quality unagi to me, but this one was different. This Anago is nice and soft, with a yuzu-tasting, almost herbal marination to it. I guess all these unconventional sauces and marinations are one of the defining features of Kanazawa sushi. I mean, the Tokyo-style sushi that I'm used to seems to be more about the raw, unadulterated juiciness of the fish itself. But based on the sushi I had here in Kanazawa, it seems like they're more likely to grill their seafood, and they're more likely to use some interesting seasonings and sauces. Now, I can't really say I prefer one style of sushi over the other, but it was definitely nice to try this out as a change of pace. But hey, feel free to decide for yourself by checking out my other omakase video about a 20-piece sushi feast in the Tokyo area. It's one of the best meals I've had in Japan, and I think you're gonna like it a lot. I got that link down below in the description box. So don't forget to vote down below in the comments section on what video I make next, and I hope you have a real nice day.